And we're back. The last thing that we're going to do today on the same drawing is, on the same paper that you drew your steps, we're going to shift over and draw a fence. So I'm going to actually move my vanishing point. Yours is still going to end up being in the center of your page, but I've just zoomed in so that we have a little bit better view of what's going on down here. We're going to be drawing some repeated vertical lines that lead toward our vanishing point. And this is a really helpful technique to know. This relates to using the X like we did to find the midpoint. It's a little bit more complicated, so I'm going to have you actually write down the steps that go along with this so that you can repeat this on your own. It'll be used when we do sidewalks. It'll be used if you're going to do a wall with several windows that are all the same size or several doors that are in a row. This technique is super helpful. So what we'll do to start with is we're going to start with a fence post, and I think we're going to keep it pretty simple. We're not going to worry about making them rectangular posts, but we may add some thickness to them so that they're not just a straight line. We may end up turning them into really long, skinny cylinders like round fence posts. So the first thing I'd like you to do is to the left of your central vanishing point, and let's make this all happen below our eye level just to avoid confusion. If you draw it up here, what's going to happen is our horizon line will end up interfering with some of our measuring lines that are really critical. So I think just to avoid that possible mistake, what we'll do is we'll shift the drawing down below the horizon line, and I'd like you to maybe make your first fence post about halfway between your central vanishing point and the left edge of your paper. And we'll make it, you know, less than half of this remaining distance on your paper. I can show you how big my paper is here, but so we won't have it clear down at the bottom edge, but we'll keep it an inch or two below the horizon line. So go ahead, make sure that this fence post is as truly vertical as you can make it be. Let me see if I can figure out the best way to do this. Just give me a nice straight line here. And again, it can be any height you want, but what will make things a little bit simpler is if you can make it a distance that's really easily divisible by two. That'll save you a little bit of effort in the next step. So I'm going to make mine 3 inches long. And while you're there, you might as well go ahead and mark what the midpoint is. So for me, this is going to be the midpoint of that line. So step one, let's go ahead and write this down. Step one, draw the first post. Step two is to extend guidelines from the top and the bottom of your first post all the way to the central vanishing point. So write guidelines from top and bottom of post number one. To CVP, central vanishing point. And let me pull this over a little bit so you can see my notes there. Okay. So all of the other posts that we'll be drawing will be getting smaller and smaller as they lead toward the horizon line. But the top of every post needs to be along this top guideline, and the bottom of every post will end up falling along that second guideline. Now, the second post you can put anywhere you want between here and the vanishing point, but after that point, we need to use a system so that the third one is evenly spaced from the second one. So I'm going to go ahead and put a second one in here, just maybe an inch to the right, closer to the vanishing point. And I'm just using this edge as my guide so that I make sure that they stay really parallel. I don't think we're going to worry about adding thickness right now to the post. We're just going to, we'll just get the basic principle down, and then I can talk about how to add thickness later if we need to know that. Okay, so now step three, write down, draw in second post. And again, it can be pretty much anywhere you want between here, but if you made it too close, then everything's going to get super minuscule and you won't be able to see what you're doing. So I would just make it about an inch or so from the point where your first post was. So let's go ahead and number these as well. Okay, so I wrote down, draw a second post to the right of the first post. If your fence is over here, it's going to be opposite of that, of course. Now step four is to find the midpoint of post one. So find the midpoint of post one. We already did that as we were measuring it, but if you didn't remember to do that, go ahead and do a really careful measurement. The more accurate you are here, the better this is going to work out. So you're finding the halfway point. And from this point now, we can extend that line all the way back to the central vanishing point, and that's going to divide, that's going to find the midpoint of all the other posts too. We're going to need to know where that is in order to make this process work. So draw a really light line or a dotted line to indicate the halfway. So we've got the halfway point of post one, this is the halfway point of post two. Mark where the halfway point of post two is for us. Now this is where it gets a little confusing, so make sure you're focused. And we're going to go from, and you can start at the bottom or the top, but just, you know, pick a system and stick with it. We're going to go from the top of post one through the midpoint of post two, and wherever it happens to cross this baseline is where the base of post three is going to be. So you add a line from the top of post one through midpoint of post two, and it will lead us to the base of post three. That's kind of shorthand, but so from the top of post one through the midpoint, and again, be as accurate as you can when you're putting that midline in so that you don't get more distortion, and wherever that happens to cross that baseline, again, these are just measuring guides, so you're not actually going to have to draw this in as a solid line, but I do want to see your dotted line so that I know that you're using this process and not just guessing. You cannot just take your ruler and start dividing that evenly, or what's going to happen is these will seem to be getting farther and farther apart as they're getting farther away from us. So that will be exactly opposite of what you want it to look like. We need them to get shorter and closer together as they move toward the central vanishing point. So this becomes the bottom of post three. So now that we know where that is, all it takes is a vertical line right through that point. Again, the more precise you can be with your alignment, the better this is going to work out for you. And that becomes post three. And then it's just a matter of repeat sequence. So you go back to, you're going to actually jump to the second post. So actually, before 0.6, we should do 5.5, jump to post two, and then repeat. So we jump to this next one. From the top of post two through the midpoint of post three will help us find the base of post four. So top of post one, line up your ruler right through the middle of post two. From the top of post two through the middle of post three, we'll find the base of post number four. And bring in one more vertical line there. You can repeat that as far as you want toward the vanishing point. If you're doing it right, they need to get closer and closer together. And remember, you have to keep jumping. So for this next one, we jump to the top of post three, go through the midpoint of post four to find the base of post five. And that is the point where we'll bring a vertical in to find the location of that fifth post. So this is, again, a really useful technique to learn It takes a little bit of practice, but it's really not a very complex process once you get the basics down. So do write this down. If you missed the description, you can replay that or pause it so that it really makes sense to you. But this works for fence posts. It works for, you know, if you're doing telephone poles, or if you want to have, you know, if we're drawing it this way, you know, you could also do it in one point perspective. If this were our horizon line, we could divide the horizontals in half and extend it back and do the same process to create sidewalk tiles or ceiling tiles or other things. So it's a super versatile technique to know. It works just the same way if we are talking about two-point perspective. So once you've figured it out in one-point perspective, half the work is done to getting a two-point perspective drawing constructed using the same technique.